Tall Can Listening. Yes, sir. Welcome to another episode of Tall Can Listening. As always, I'm Nauf. You good?
I'm sorry. My boys. Oh, I'm a little IPA.
And today, we have a special guest, San Antonio rapper, DiversiD.
So, what's up? Man, I appreciate the invite. I'm glad to be here.
Yes, sir. We appreciate you, dog. We know you have a busy schedule.
Something like that. How close do I need to be in my life?
Nah, you good. Just pull it, whatever you want. However you want to talk, bro. So look, you have a project coming up, right? I heard about it.
Yeah, what'd you hear?
Just dropping mid-March.
Nah.
Oh, then she lied to me.
Nah, it's fine.
Oh, okay. I was like, oh, fuck. I got wrong information already.
He's all scratching his nose
down right now. No, yeah, let me get my pen, bro.
I got a little something popping up. It's lined up. We've been planning on it. We've been consistently getting everything aligned, and it's always a lot of moving parts. So, just gotta make sure everything lines up.
How many songs?
Still up for the baby.
Okay. Is it so over on the?
It'll be small. It'll be smooth for right now.
Okay.
And then something else is lined up right after that.
How do you feel about like the albums with like 20 plus songs? Or are you more of like the six? Seven, nine. Because I know nowadays it's like.
And some skits.
Yeah, oh, the skits are old school, yeah.
Hell yeah. Now, for me, I can't sit and listen to something that long. I need, even if they're quick, like a cool, like 12 max, I'm straight on.
Because I'll see artists drop shit, and I'm in my head, as you know, because I'm older, like Luda would drop 16 songs, hour and 10. Now it's like, oh.
Nah, but that was. Except common right? Back in the day.
Yeah, so now
that was a thing.
I listened to Don Tripp. 9 songs, 26 minutes. I'm like, what? God damn. Like, but it's a thing. Like,
and even if you want to like re-listen, like how many times are you going to keep listening to it? Where if you wanted to re-listen back then,
yeah,
and you didn't get music as often back then either.
That's true. It's a different time now. That's crazy. Do you have a title for it yet or not yet? Oh,
damn.
You can't say nothing yet.
I already said too much.
Oh, shit. I was just getting info from your manager.
But
my bad.
You did get a snippet.
We heard 4 songs. You said 2 of them were unreleased. Or 1 of them was unreleased.
1 of them's unreleased. 1 of them's super raw. So you got like a pre-done one.
Can I say the name of my favorite? You tell me if it was one of the released ones. It was a SSDD Volume 3.
Yeah.
That's a part of a different project.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, see, that one's like, this is the one
too
I like.
Much information. Like, yeah.
right. Too much info is getting spread. I'm sorry.
Oh, no, that's cool. That's cool.
We'll just blur it off.
Right.
Oh,
you're good.
Is That's Fire going to be on the album? Or is that just strictly single? Okay, yeah. That's fire.
I appreciate it.
That's a dope ass song. Well, I mean, out of the ones you sent us today, what was your favorite? Personal favorite out of the 4?
I would say, they're all different vibes. That's why I said that, really. So it depends on the mood. I would say right now the Careless Cycle one.
Okay.
Just a whole different vibe.
Yeah.
It's something you can ride to, smoke to, chill to, drink to.
One of the ones you sent us was actually playing behind us, the Cypher.
Oh, yeah.
How was that?
Hard.
Yeah, it was.
Hard. Tough. Shout out to Yoda.
Yeah.
Y'all, you and Lil Yachty have a good chemistry going on, and I heard when y'all song together, that's when I first like, oh shit, and I heard both y'all together, and I was like, god damn, these fools are killing it. Like, you can just tell, you know, when some people get together, it's like, oh, it's alright. With this, I was like, natural.
Yeah, I appreciate it. Shout out to Tiny Toon, shout out to Future Relic.
Yeah.
But yeah, everything was, it was the first time I really got to work with Yoda, and all of them, honestly, those Future Relic I featured on before or something, but
yeah,
it was just a tough situation to have to be with such a great artist.
Yeah,
but like it was fun. It was fun.
It's like, does he give you time like write your stuff with him, or he goes in the booth and his stuff's re-recorded?
This one was one where we all did separately.
Separately. Okay. So then, like when you came in, he had his part, and then yours was you know, blanked out just with instrumental.
Yeah, we did.
You got it last or what?
I think it was maybe 1 verse on there.
Okay.
So we don't really, we just kind of went and just ate, try to eat.
And then they mixed it together.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Yeah. I mean, that's tough, right? Now you're not hearing no feedback.
Exactly. you don't know if you did well. You don't know if you sounded
trash. Yeah, you want to know the comparison.
Right?
See, and like people listen to those songs, they're like, I wouldn't even think that that's how y'all made that. You know what I mean?
That's tight. Right. And the way like everybody approached it differently, so it wasn't like who knows what you're going to go up against.
Yeah.
But it wasn't really like a competition thing. It was just like, I need to make sure I stay on my own.
Yeah.
And it was smooth.
I mean, you're a pretty fast lyricist, spinner. How many songs you push out a day are you trying to?
I take time with them.
Taking time?
I take time with
That's
them.
Good.
I'll do one in a day and like start on some ideas, but I like to take time with them. Even if I finish it, I'll sit and listen to it for a little while and see if there's
to make stuff sure.
you can add to
so
it.
So like, you don't have like many projects at once. You're just one and done and then on to the next right there.
No, they're all like going on.
At the so they're all rough drafts. Okay, so there's
right
going. Gotcha.
Like rough draft, and I'll listen to it for a little while. Come back, because the way I write is different. I'll like just have a song play. Say if you're a producer, you send it to me.
Yeah.
I won't even know what I'm finna listen to, so I'll just play the email and then I'll record whatever I say. And half the songs that I do, that's what I'm doing. So it turns that into words later.
So is it on first reaction what you're doing? Pretty much
the flow of it a lot of times, yeah,
because your first reaction is probably the best, so you're like, all right, let me just
can I ask something?
Yeah,
do you write and then, or do you just like say punch, all right, go back, listen to it, say punch, or
it depends. Usually I'll write it though.
It just depends.
Usually I'll write it. Yeah.
Okay, so I was trying to look up your album. You only have two official albums,
right?
Dang. Yeah. Well, I mean, I'm just wondering, what's the reason? Because you take time.
Took too much time.
Okay.
And then
because it was a 3-year gap, right?
A good gap. It's a gap now, honestly. That's why, you know, a lot of times when you overthink something, it's different from whenever you trying to make it perfect. Because then you'll see certain shit or you'll hear certain shit and you'll be like, nah, that's not it. And then you start losing confidence because you keep hearing shit that was wrong.
And then you keep going back into
right?
it. Yeah. Mm.
So a lot of this stuff, like when I go back, I'm like, nah, this actually, but it doesn't fit with what I'm doing right now. Mm. So now a bunch of, when I said a lot's lining up, everything's lining up to where now it's just getting ready. I did all the hard shit first.
Yeah, that makes sense. Tall camp. Another quick, how long have you been rapping? Because like I was telling you outside, social media, we've known each other for a while. So, I mean, how long have you been rapping?
For me right now, I would say like take being serious.
Yeah.
Shit, what year is it, 2022? Shit, like 13, 14 years?
Yeah.
13, 14 years. So it's pretty seasoned.
So do you feel like, are you in your prime right now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, no, it's still getting better.
Oh, shit.
Yeah,
He's like LeBron.
Still a rookie. Oh, yeah, just.
Yeah, after time, like, it's just certain shit that you can, if you keep trying to, like, learn, you'll keep expanding, really.
Hell yeah. Who was your biggest influences?
I say early on was Kamina.
Fuck the GOAT.
Chimina.
You that Chimina guy? Yeah. He's my favorite rapper all time.
All time?
All time.
Yes. His
too. Like it's,
What did he drop recently? Has he dropped something?
With Toby.
Oh.
Been broke.
Yeah.
You're right.
Fire.
Okay.
All right. I'm sorry. Right. I don't mean to
go. Go ahead. You got E on the side.
Yeah, I'm just here, dog. What's one album you can listen to, no skips?
Oh, bro, did you read my...
Yeah, no, but it's always something that
that's
like
a good question.
Ask, something.
That's fine, that's why y'all brothers.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
One album
you can... That's why y'all brothers.
Yeah.
You know,
maybe all-time favorite, whatever, you know, something you can listen to, no skips.
Hey, I got probably like two, maybe three. I'll say Word of Mouth, Ludacris.
Yes.
Yep.
Whenever it came out, that was the first like actual album I had like learned all the words to every song. I didn't even know what the fuck I was saying. I'm some of this shit. But I go back and I listen. So I don't know if it's because it was such a great album, like it still bumps, but like for the nostalgia purposes.
Yeah, I think it still bumps.
I mean, I think it's just the nostalgia that gives it more
right
polish for us.
And Luda seems like he goes under the radar a lot with when people mention.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
For mentions, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
It's because that motherfucker's making millions off them.
Movies.
Yeah. He's like, well, it's been a fucking decade, right? Like, I can't fucking get away from these shits. I keep making money.
What was the other album?
What was the the first Drake one, the mixtape one.
Take Care? No, that's not it.
The one before that. Thank You
So
Later.
Far Gone?
So Far Gone.
Yeah, okay.
Damn, he has a lot of albums in that.
Yeah, he's got a lot.
So Far Gone. And then he's like on that like silhouette on his...
Yeah. And I think same thing, just
that's
like...
a good one.
Like around that time, just I was listening to music in a different way.
And he was the first one to do like that. And then like Cudi came out, and I was like, oh, this motherfucker is taking my soul.
And Wiz?
Yeah, Wiz, dog. All of them came out. And I was like just chipping at the time, and I was like learning everything. It was crazy. See, and then what's your that last one?
Reasonable Doubt.
Oh, man. Some Jay-Z?
Yeah.
Damn, I love me some Jay-Z.
Yeah.
I like the American Gangster album. That shit
did you go to his concert when he was here in SA?
No, I didn't.
Oh, that shit was live.
Way to call him out, bro.
I'm just asking.
Some fan.
Way to really call him out.
It's rare.
I know.
These big artists that come out.
Yeah, that's another thing that sucks. San Antonio don't get shit.
They don't get love, dog.
It's always Houston, Dallas.
You ever look at the tour dates?
It's always Houston, Dallas.
Austin.
Austin twice.
Yeah. Like, drop 2 hours in San Antonio, bro.
Yeah, I don't know. Remember they before people were scared because they were snatching chains.
Hell yeah. Back in the day, dog, our people weren't fucking around back when we were young.
Hey, I see your chain.
Nah, I was about to say, man. I was like, I like to go over the drip on our rappers coming in. Let's see. What you wearing on top?
Chilling. On the head. All Money Is Legal. That's my homeboy that's a comedian from Louisiana, his cousin from Houston.
Okay.
So whenever I go to Houston, I try to reach out, and whenever I have events, I try to bring them down. And
see, man, we would love to have a comedian on with these, like, you know what I mean? Like, we get some comedian.
Aren't you a comedian?
Get us a comedian, bro.
Yeah. Wait, we don't care what.
What you talking about?
Cliff will do it.
See, I've seen him on Facebook. I don't have him as a friend, but I see he's all over the place, bro.
Cliff.
I need to add him.
Cliff and Simmons.
Put the word in for us.
I got you. Right now, Cliff and Simmons. Basically, like, on the comedy side of everything in San Antonio, me and him are like brothers.
Yeah.
So, like, everything that I'm doing on the music side, I feel like he's doing on the comedy side.
That's dope, bro.
Well, DiversiD gave me an IPA, man. It was pretty good.
How you feeling right now?
Good. It was good. Mixing too much.
You're getting fucked up, bro.
I brought something else, actually.
Oh, shit.
And I felt like it'll be a monumental moment. I haven't done this in a long time.
God.
But I felt like...
I am not... I'm not working tomorrow. This one.
You mean you're not working?
They got an All-American flavor.
Oh, you gave me the 13, bro?
I
got 13. God damn.
Oh, fuck.
Hey, all right.
Y'all going back.
Talk can first. All
right, this is...
We got some Four Locos.
Man, bring me back.
Hey, you still fucking Four Locos?
It's all 20. I didn't have it. I thought y'all said no, but...
They're doing it. They're going to drink it now.
There we go.
It's open. Cheers.
Cheers.
I'm calling in tomorrow.
You don't know how many times I see these shit delivering, like when I'm delivering them, I'm like,
God. It tastes dangerously good.
Look at X, she's already gone.
Bro.
Wait a minute. I remember these listening.
Who's got the most alcohol? You gave me the least.
Like more potent back in the day, no?
I thought they were the same.
You got 12, I had 13.9. Oh, wow, you setting us up?
Wow.
You got the
USA. Hey.
Watermelon, sour apple.
What's the flavor today?
Good.
Sour apple.
Where do you see the flavor at?
It's on the can.
It's just Four Loko USA.
America's
You're in America,
flavor.
Dog.
America. Biden.
It tastes like freedom.
Freedom of speech.
And I'm owning a gun.
I appreciate the surprise. And I'll be telling him tomorrow how much I hate you.
Well, they used to put something else in it, right?
Yeah.
Back in the day?
No, I'm telling you. Like, and then the MDs.
You want to see?
I passed it. I was like,
yeah, bro. I get shivers when I pass those.
I appreciate the gift. That's the best gift we've ever had.
I know, honestly, yeah, this
you caught me off guard. I saw the bag. I just thought it was basic, like beer. Like, oh, he's brought some cool.
Oh, he's brought some t-shirts.
Yes.
Oh, like, I'm getting a Blockbuster t-shirt, man. Hell yeah.
Let me see. Who's the biggest artist you've opened for?
1B.
Oh, when was that?
Oh shit.
One of the early Smooth Vegas shows.
Okay.
You meet him.
Premiere. I met him at a different time.
Okay. Oh, so you don't get to meet the artist you open for, huh? Or it depends on like.
Depends on the timing. Depends on the artist. Depends on how they feel. Because sometimes, they'll come and they're like. They don't even want girls around.
Yeah.
So you don't really know.
They don't want to do. They say get off.
And then sometimes they'll charge just to go see him. So
we don't love them hoes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So you never know. He wasn't like that, but I would say it would be Bun B or Royce.
The Fine Nine? Oh, shit. Yeah.
Underrated again. Yeah, he. No, I love Royce.
Slaughterhouse, bro.
Cold, right?
Lyricist, dog. I swear to God, man. I don't know, man. A lot of people just. I bring up his name.
Well, you bring up Royce. How do you feel about Joe Budden?
Oh, stop.
Duh.
He's not. He's cold. But
compared to everybody else in the squad?
Yeah.
Royce.
Joe was my favorite.
Just because he bald like you? Is that what it is?
I'm sorry, dog.
Out of Slaughterhouse?
Yes, honestly.
Okay, if you can
rank the Slaughterhouse members.
1 to 4.
Crooked Eye, Royce, Joel. Joe Biden.
Joe Budden's just got an ego, man.
It's the biggest piece of dog that I have ever heard.
I like Joe, but
okay, like he
was cool. He's the friend like you don't want to bring around the girls.
Right.
He's cool.
Well, I love Joe Budden.
Well, like doesn't he like guys too? Doesn't he like guys
to this day?
Well, what? No, I mean, it's 2023, bro.
He said don't bring around the girls, but I'm like, it don't matter. You can't bring around nobody.
You better get canceled.
Look, if Joe Buddy hears it, call us out, man. That's a lot of publicity, bro. I don't give a fuck.
I don't give a fuck either.
There's no such thing as bad publicity.
I want to be on that show.
Yeah.
I want to ask, how was the Zero concert? How was it opening for Zero? And why the fuck was that concert so long?
How many acts was it?
Dog, at least 20. I got there at 7:30 thinking he'll have 4 openers, he'll be on stage by 9:10.
Oh, he wanted me to go.
He was probably still at the airport at that time.
he's like,
I'm just flying into this shithole.
I was mad, my cousin was mad because he had to work at 4 the next morning. And I told him, it'll be over by 11.
So
bro.
Did I.
It ran right.
He only wanted to go, yeah.
He's all like, yo, Zero will be on by 9. I said, no, he's going to be on by like midnight, bro. Yeah.
Well, not even that.
Well, now I'm going to get home too.
DiversiD jumped on at midnight.
Right. I was on at midnight. He went a little later.
But I mean, how was it being like the main opener right before him?
That was cool. It was it's
you didn't hear me?
No, I didn't hear you.
Oh, they will not to get home till like the next midnight.
Oh, I got a story. We'll go to that.
That night?
Yeah.
Oh, it's hurt.
I can't wait to talk about it. Man, yeah. Wait, when it's over. I can't do it all on air.
I mean, we'll bring it up. I'll cut it if I feel like it. It depends on the
Hey. No, get like right here, bro. And then we'll start talking about it, dog. Get like right there.
Oh, yeah, it'll get there.
Yeah.
We'll play by ear.
Yeah. So, go ahead. How was it?
It was cool. It was, the crowd weren't fucking with a lot of people.
No. Okay. I liked 3 of the acts, one of them being you. The other one was some white boy that was early on. Like, maybe the first or second one. And then from there, it was another one. Things started getting blurry. And then you came on, I was like, oh, fuck yeah, finally someone I know.
20 artists and you don't know them, that's crazy, right?
That, yeah, it's like, you know the promoter made some money that night.
20 artists?
God damn it. Tickets was $50, $40, something like that?
Damn, was well, like trial season or what?
They're
tryouts or what, bro? God damn, it sounded like 20 artists. Who's next? You got 5 minutes, bitch. Hurry up.
No, yeah.
Dog, I'm telling you, bro.
Simon Cowell's in the back.
Right? God damn.
Yeah, that shit. Yeah, they won on that, I'm sure. And then it was a skip the line ticket. It was like 2 sets of tickets. But luckily, when I went... I did something that I knew was different from everybody else, so I went like serious.
Two sets of tickets?
Yeah, like, was,
this is a get in, this is stay in. Oh man, what kind of shit? Yo, he hold y'all, bro. Come on. That's funny, man. Come on.
Right.
God damn. My man, bro. Go ahead. Look at tryouts. One thing you get for 5 artists. The other one, you know, the rest of the night.
It was over 1,000 people. So
that shit is packed, bro. My short ass sat. Well, I was right by your table, so you knew where I was at. on the step, so I could see.
You lost what you're right.
they showed a lot of love to him, though. It was cool because for like. I never just saw a regular, unless it's like commanding.
Yeah.
Bun B didn't have that many people.
It was, yeah, you know, it was what I'm for sure, though.
So it's cool. It's a cool vibe.
I had a question. So there was one song you did. It was, I think the last song. The lights were off, and it was very emotional.
That's the one I was talking about, yeah.
Me and my cousin were like, no, oh, this shit. I liked it, because I like that deep shit.
Yeah.
Is that on Spotify?
Yes.
What is it called? Because I was like, I want to fucking hear that song, bro.
It's called Spitting Image.
Okay, mm-hmm. Now I know, because we were fucking trying to figure that shit out, because it was deep. And the way you had, like, you were just going, like, acapella, lights off. I was like, oh, shit, you can really hear, like, the emotion in it.
Yeah. Yeah, I knew I was going to be 20. Yeah. I was gonna say 20, but me and 7. It's going to be, like, 20 artists.
But number 7, come to the stage, please. Number 7, you're on deck.
Hey,
DiversiD.
You
fucking hate me.
You know, pull the receipt up. Oh, I'm 7. Shit, man. Yeah, I'm...
Check your name.
Yeah, so I wanted to stand out, so I was like, all right, let me do this. So if they still hate it, they'll remember it, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I was like, let me see if I can cut the lights out, because they didn't do it at first.
Yeah.
That was embarrassing.
Yeah, I remember.
Cut it.
Nah, man.
I was like, sorry. Yeah. I'm just go if you want to.
So what were you doing? You were like, just like... switching, like, just talking.
We
to, like,
found a, as soon as I got there, I knew I wanted to do it.
Okay.
So we found who the person was in charge of the lights and the sound, and he was right by where our booth was.
Perfect.
So he was like, "Yeah, I got you. Just let me know when."
Yeah.
And then I tapped whoever, and I was like, "Can you let them know when?" And they're like, "Yeah, yeah." And I guess when they were like, "Hey, sir." He was gone.
Oh, he's in a bathroom break. He's out there.
Oh, shit.
He's trying to get in. I got a ticket right here, man.
What's your other ticket?
I'm the DJ, bro. Come on.
This is the one to stay in. Nah,
man, back in line, bro.
So once his other ticket got cleared and he came back, it was at enough time where it still made sense.
Okay.
And,
He's out there like any moment now. They're gonna turn off.
This shit'll make you nervous for real.
No, I believe it.
Like 10 seconds probably feels like a minute up there, bro.
Mm-hmm. And like, you kind of in your head know like how it could go, how it should go, or you wanted to go. It was none of them. So I was like, because if they're like, no, we can't, I'm like, my fault anyway. I'm making a little joke.
Yeah.
But they're like, yeah, he's gonna do it, and I was like. Well, all right, now. Let me go. I don't want to lose the momentum. And then as I was going, it got real quiet. And I was trying to look at people's face as I was getting more passionate. And I was like, they're listening.
Yeah.
All right, cool. You got to respect it at least.
You see Nob crying?
Yeah, no, you just see me. In the back, I was like, yeah, girl.
He's all, I got him.
Nah,
got
him. It just went.
Got
him.
Got that motherfucker.
You had me bad there, bro.
I appreciate it.
It stuck in my head ever since. And I was like, I'm going to talk to him on the show, so I'll bring it up there.
Yeah, it, so then once I did it, and I could, it was quiet. And then I started hearing, oh, and I was like, are they booing?
No, okay. Me and my cousin.
Me? You're going to boo me?
Number 6, you're on. Number 6,
you're on. Me and my cousin thought the same thing, bro. And we were like, getting into it, we heard the same thing. I was like, they're not booing DiversiD, right? Like,
I'm ruined.
I was like, fuck. We didn't like his music anyway. No.
We'll mark that down too. Hell yeah. So they started turning the cheers, and it was like, oh, it's already getting loud. I was like, cool. Yeah. And after that, everything was kind of smooth.
That's good, man.
Where was it? Was it nerve wracking?
I'm sure it was too quick. my words slurring.
Was it nerve wracking to wait that long? Like, did it piss you off? Did you know you were going to have to wait 6 hours to get on stage?
The time I was given was an hour and a half earlier.
God!
Yesterday. I was supposed to perform yesterday. But I'm really comfortable on stage.
Yeah.
So, like...
Anybody?
Nah, not really. I like to get there with enough time. I don't like to show up and like, you're on, go.
Yeah, she's not rushed.
Fuck, no, I hate that.
So, I was like, he was chilling. Mm-hmm. I mean, well, I bet you if you're not performing and you're not in the crowd, you're just like...
Well, he was selling merch.
Well, there you go.
Yeah, my cousin, yeah, he bought.
Asked him if he was stressing him selling merch for 6 hours.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. So, we did a tall can draft a few months back. I don't know if you remember it. We drafted
Oh.
With the Big Sam Heard.
Got the paper. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Create your own hit songs with Santonio based artists. Okay. I want to know how you feel about the list, because you were drafted.
Hey, right,
you
feel like,
I appreciate you.
Not that you think about you.
How do you feel about the draft? And
so how did it go? So these were the first ones.
Yeah, and no, it was first, and then Snake.
So then I didn't, you know what I mean?
Okay, yeah.
So on this one, I got back to back. So I was like, you know what I mean?
That's hard.
So is that a solid song? Because I'm on.
I mean, everything is great until right here.
I don't know. X was like, I just throw Nolf in there.
Yeah. We got two producers. We got you on the hook, obviously.
You heard?
Obviously. Hell yeah.
Who that Jack Bone?
You don't even remember?
Only three.
I think
I would switch that two for him now.
Hey, just because he's right here. Don't.
No, only because. Only because I heard some more recent shit, and even the one he let us.
Nah, that X kissing ass right now.
Either way, I appreciate it.
I got you.
But can you blame me for going old school?
Not at all. See? Not at all.
What do you got? Third degree?
Oh, yeah.
All he did was take. Definitely. Nolf was taking potential guests. He wasn't thinking about real artists.
If I can get my Chris on here,
what I want on my show.
So, who has the best collab? I know you're gonna say yourself, but I mean X's team.
Oh man, you got Angel in there.
Oh, so you fuck with Angel?
Yeah.
Ain't nobody think easy too either. That's crazy.
Yes,
this was earlier.
Yeah,
on.
It was earlier.
Yeah.
That's you can put him on the spot
because you got Yoda over here, Kyle.
You gotta hurt some feelings out here, bro.
I mean all of them are hits, obviously, but the range of artists here is kind of tough, but we're making a hit for sure.
Oh, okay. All right.
Thank you.
So X picked the best squad. Because I'm on it. Hey.
So you lost, but you won.
Hey, what's that? Exactly. I'm gonna start playing the hook.
That's our first song. This is all played. That feature. Weird.
Oh, shout out. So you thought we showed you the collab there. Let's lead to another question. A dream collab for you. It could be local or mainstream, or if you want to do one of each.
Or not mainstream.
I'll say mainstream. Oh, who would it be? Who would yours be?
Chamillionaire.
Chamillionaire.
Well, I know I'm gonna get a hit with Drake.
If I have Cannon live on the
screen. Oh, you're right. X thing is smart. He said with Drake he gets a hit.
Definitely get a hit.
A hit. Coming from us growing up.
Yeah, but Cam won't give us like.
You know, okay. Side note.
And then get this. Like you get to record a song with him, so you know how that motherfucker works now.
Yeah.
A little bit of taste. But how he
childhood artist. Childhood artist, always growing up, I always wanted Magno.
Oh,
that's great. You know what I mean?
Oh, Magno.
Underrated.
Punchline.
I thought about doing that.
Have you ever asked him about a feature?
I did too.
He did it in charge, and I was like, well, I'm going to have to hold off on this.
Because, he was in high school.
Yeah, I was like,
he was still buzzing.
Yo, at the time.
Yeah, for sure, bro.
Do you remember how much he said?
Say it.
I want to say, like,
10 bags.
Two G's?
That's not bad.
I want to say, but I don't remember. I just want a number out there.
16 bars?
Yeah. And that was when he was, popping on the ground. I asked Tum Tum for a shout out. Like, just like, hey, yo, a minute skit for my mixtape. 500. I was like, I ain't got
500?
Never mind. I mean, Tum Tum was fire.
That's kind of tight.
Yeah,
I mean, fuck.
I just wanted a 1 minute.
How much you charge?
It depends.
I mean, we're talking numbers.
No, it depends. I'm not really crazy taxing. Depends.
Actually, you know what? Don't even talk about it. You know what? Keep the numbers to yourself. You know,
You say it, we'll bleep it out.
we could do that. Say it right now.
Yeah, no, I'll say right now before all the shit that I have lined up.
Damn!
I just say that's
fucking good.
It's fucking cheap.
But that go. I mean,
not cheap, but
damn,
I thought it was like 500. Yeah. I thought it was gonna be up in there with like that. That's why I thought you charge more.
Yeah, and
not that he's,
it's just because a lot of the people you rate whatever price you want for yourself, obviously, but like for me, a lot comes with it because if I'm on your song, I'm gonna treat it like it's my song.
Yeah,
and I wouldn't agree to it if I didn't like the music. Or respect the artist's hustle.
You know? Have you ever told someone no? Yeah. Oh. Yeah, and how did you, I mean, are you polite about it? Like, I don't really fuck with it like that. Or like, just are you just like, him. Fuck you, bro, that's ass.
Just block him.
It's like, oh, you gotta hit my manager.
Oh, so that's why Knopf had to go with your manager.
he was trying to go through the rock. Yeah.
He's like, Knopf, yeah, go ahead, go ahead, reach out to her, man.
And she got times confused. I'm like, I'm just gonna talk to DiversiD and
say, right, fuck that. Yeah, so I would say,
I was on 9:30.
No, that was late as hell.
I'm tired.
Our kids gotta go to work outside all day. Damn.
Bitch, fucking.
Right. That's our fault.
Bitch, I do.
But we're here. It made for a better story.
Yeah.
You built a memory
together. No, at least you came.
You know what I mean?
Come, that's like, what she said. So I'm at.
Oh my god. At least you came.
Four Loko.
Oh, shit.
What was I saying?
Oh, yeah.
What the fuck
was
saying?
That's what we're saying.
Tall camp.
So you play any sports? Can you hoop?
Yeah, I'm in the middle of an injury.
Oh, where?
Y'all be hooping?
Yeah, we just hooped yesterday and no one showed up.
Right there at your shit?
No, my court sucked, though. I ran to the gym yesterday on, the south side?
Yeah, about almost around San Mission Road. Yeah, like 25.
Y'all been hooping this whole time.
Yeah, man.
I was playing like 2-3 times a week.
No, we don't do that.
he never tells anybody, though.
Well, because I don't know who hoops.
Okay.
Can you hoop, though?
I was decent. Okay. I got a torn meniscus.
Oh,
so
shit.
So I don't know if it healed. I got to do another MRI.
We'll find out when we hoop.
Hey, this just blows up. I feel so bad.
I remember when E tore his meniscus.
Yeah, I thought I tore it, alright.
What was it?
I don't know. Remember my knee hurt and the next day I
broke his ankle.
Oh, it's fine.
I'd be crossing.
I took his shit. Oh! You know what I mean?
We gotta get you out there.
Yeah, we ain't
got okay, so are y'all cold?
See me on the court, big dog. See me on the goddamn court. I mean,
he
this guy's all right.
So just worry about him.
Yeah,
I try. So I'm not PJ Tucker. I'm not going to get cardio.
We're decent.
Yeah, we're decent.
Okay. No, so no, if y'all...
They decent.
Here we go.
What's the draft order if y'all are playing?
We've always talked about this.
X is about to get mad.
Number one pick right here.
X is about to get mad.
Go ahead.
One, two,
dog.
Three.
Are you fucking?
No, see, he doesn't like that. When I play defense, I'm the only one that he can't body. That he always gets mad about.
I like to be physical.
Oh, so you down low.
No, he loves the physicality of it.
Now I'm gonna talk some shit. I'm gonna go like that.
And it's like, bro, we're just having fun.
I'm not having fun.
That's exactly what it is.
I'm that guy.
Tight.
So stay off him. Just guard me, and we're just gonna chill.
No, this, 3-point this line. Guy moves pretty good.
3-point?
He can shoot.
I think I seen clips of you playing.
Yeah, we out you.
For a bigger guy, he can move, man. I'm telling you.
We out you.
It's in your like core. You know,
we out
you. He had to cross that border quick.
He got
that. Oh, God damn.
That's why he's dark little.
Oh, man.
Run!
Oh, hell no!
You have any more questions? So you can hoop, that's great.
I'm decent.
We'll get you out there, though.
I'll definitely break some ankles.
Oh, I mean, we're not crazy, but like we get down.
You know, you're crazy.
Like, we're not some bitches out there. I tell you that.
We're probably around the same. Like,
yeah.
I'll break some ankles.
Decent pace.
Get past everybody and like. Miss
actually, hold up. Stand up real quick for me, though.
Oh, size check. Size check.
Oh god.
Oh yeah. We all right. Yeah, we gonna be all right.
Yeah,
damn,
Sean.
5'10".
There you go.
I'm 6'6".
I'm 6 flat.
Ain't no way.
5'11 and a half. Top 5 movies of all time.
Hold on. Have you seen Forrest Gump?
Oh, God.
Have you seen Forrest Gump?
Yes. The number one movie.
The number one?
Thank you. This guy's never seen Forrest Gump and refuses to watch it.
Yeah, I remember when y'all talked about it.
Oh,
he's had like 3 years to watch it and he still hasn't.
Trust
even
me.
Even when it was on Netflix.
Fuck, right, the DVD, right? Look right there. How this fucking dress.
My cousin gave it to me.
What the fuck?
Yeah, sick.
My cousin gave it to me. I was like, watch it.
You're like depriving yourself from like good movie, like a good.
Sarah wants me to watch it in 30-minute intervals and like record myself.
Oh, are you sick?
No, to like
get what the fuck did she know,
to
bro?
To get a review out of it, to make it a thing.
No, now tell me what just happened in the last 30 minutes.
No, okay. Because everyone's making it a big deal.
But you gotta make it like you gotta watch the whole thing though on the same day though.
Definitely the same day.
Oh, okay, same day.
You have to, bro, right?
No, she was talking about 30 minutes this night, 30 minutes.
No, you should do 30 minutes, say something. 30 minutes, come back on.
You don't want to forget. Like
I'm telling you, like you got, it's a moment. You got to get into it. You can't stop it. That ruins it. A
lot of movies.
Hey, what's your favorite movie?
You're pissing me off already, right? Thank you. You said number one movie. Thank you.
What's your favorite movie, though?
Forrest Gump.
It really is.
Yeah, it's not a coincidence.
No, what's your favorite movie?
Huh? Bucky Larson, Born to Be a Star. Starring Nick Swardson.
That's your favorite?
Yeah.
On Rotten Tomatoes, it's like a negative.
I didn't watch it. I remember clips.
It's funny, right?
Oh, I remember y'all talking about it. I thought you were joking when you were talking about it.
Nah, he's dead serious, man.
Is it that good? You seen it?
No, no, it's not good.
It's not good.
It's like one of the worst Adam Sandler movies produced.
I mean, it's funny.
What about the other bad ones?
He likes MGK and Little Pete.
That's all you need to know.
But I also like DiversiD, so what is that?
Okay, what?
The reason you were crying?
He was like, he got me.
They were booing.
Hey, the lights are off. I'm driving home. All right. Oh, God.
God damn. So, yeah, Forrest Gump's your favorite?
Yeah, definitely Forrest Gump.
So, are you keeping up with these shows right now? You keeping up with any?
Nah, I really don't watch too much like Netflix. Or
a lot of rappers don't, man. Like that's not, you know, a lot of rappers don't.
You're too busy.
A lot of time, yeah. It's,
I feel like there's always something to do.
But I thought like if even like Wayne keeps up with sports and stuff and like movies because like he tries to keep a little relevant.
Yeah.
Favorite sports team?
Lakers. Definitely always been Lakers.
All right, man. Hey, you ready to end this shit or what?
Yeah, all right. Yeah.
Well, here's a good question that I like to ask a lot of our guests.
Wait, before you ask, just have it written down, I won't forget. Top three comedy movies.
Yes.
Go ahead. You want to start off?
I'm gonna name one and y'all name one.
Okay, go ahead. Yeah.
You're gonna hate mine.
Yeah. Bro, you can't say Bucky Larson.
Oh, well, that's
you
one.
Can't
one.
Say no, that's no.
Okay, I'll do three more.
One different. All right, that's different. Okay, I'm gonna say. Fucking Don't Be a Menace.
Awesome. Ooh, I love that shit.
I already know my other one. No, I should have said it first.
Wedding Crashers. I like that one.
The Brady Bunch movie.
Come on, man. The documentary?
No, the movie. No, it's a classic. The 90s when it's like a mockumentary.
Okay.
Y'all have never seen it?
I remember
her. They mock like
the football.
Yeah, they broke her nose.
Yeah, but like that's from the original that they like remake into like a mockumentary. Like the Bradys are living in the 90s, so it's all weird and comedic.
Oh, okay.
It's not the actual Brady Bunch. Yeah.
Appreciate.
They're still used to being in the 70s, but they're living in the 90s.
No, I mean, I watched the White Family during the Trump administration.
Damn.
It's all good.
Poly charged.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Who's it? It's your turn. Scary Movie 2.
Oh man, that's a great one.
Yeah.
All right, something I'm laughing to. Let me see.
Did you still laugh to like right now? A scene you already know is gonna happen. You still laugh.
Oh, hold on. Semi Pro. We'll fucking Will Ferrell. I got my last one. Go ahead.
I don't remember the name of the fucking movie. It's Will Ferrell and Zach Galifianakis.
Oh shit!
They're running.
It's the debate.
Is that funny?
The debate. It's fucking hilarious.
The campaign.
The campaign, I'm sorry.
Yes.
The debate.
For real?
Campaign.
Yeah.
That was boring. No, I thought it was going to be boring.
No, that shit's hilarious.
It's actually like really fucking funny.
The campaign is fire.
Yeah. Okay. I was surprised.
That's a good movie.
Your wife.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. You got to see that movie. I don't want to spoil. Last one.
Funny. What am I laughing to? First one that comes to mind, This Is the End.
Oh,
dude, hey, that was my next one, you motherfucker. Because you have all those comedic geniuses
Oh. You think they freestyled it?
Yeah. I like, want to say, because it was going to
ruin stuff. Like, you have at least three or four guys who can all produce their own fucking movies, and they've all had their own shows.
That, right. Yeah, that's
you don't think they're all just throwing in pitches and they're just cracking up improvising?
It looked like they were improvising at the time.
Yeah,
all
right, so
for me, for me, one of my favorites I can watch probably any time is a Happy Gilmore.
Okay, you going back? Yeah. Okay, I'm going to go off that. People hate this movie.
Oh, no, no.
Wait.
It's Mrs. Doubtfire. Right. Robin Williams. That's one of my favorites. I'm sorry. That one has to
people
go
are going to hate this one. That's
wait.
My,
oh! I got to come back. We gotta
okay, yeah.
We
there's so fire. Many. Yeah. Yeah. That's my boy.
That's a good one.
People yeah. hate it.
With the...
Adam Sandler yeah. and the other... Fuck,
the one that did Joe Dirt.
Yeah.
Right?
No, 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 no. Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Adam,
Andy Samberg.
Adam, Adam, Andy Samberg, bro.
That's a good one.
That's a good show.
We have another one. Here we go.
Me, Myself, and Irene.
I never saw it.
All right. Then, all right. Hey, look. Ace Ventura. Ace Ventura, pet detective, though.
Ace Ventura's overrated.
No.
Have you seen it recently?
Like 3 years ago.
That's recent enough. That's recent enough. You didn't like it?
I like stupider shit.
Stupider. You sounded stupider.
I like stupider stuff.
So I like stupider shit.
The Sitter with Jonah Hill.
Oh, that was me. That's all right.
Everybody's like,
all right. Right, well.
Oh my god. Night at the Roxbury, anybody?
Oh, that was my fifth pick. Shut up.
Oh, yeah. I thought we were in top three. I'm just shouting out these now.
Yeah,
but we can keep going.
Night at the Roxbury.
No, you keep going, just shout them out. It's whatever.
Not the rest of me.
Napoleon Dynamite.
Oh!
Yeah, bro.
Austin Powers.
Oh, dog! Austin Powers. Dog, Austin Powers is gold. Gold never. Give me some.
Anchorman?
Yeah,
Anchorman,
baby. God. Anchorman.
There's too many.
It's
a lot.
There's even like that. Oh, okay, the Hangover one.
That's it. Yeah, that's it.
Like, that was, like, one of the first movies I saw, like, at 18, 19 years old. And, like, I was, like, on the side of, like, the stairs, like, dying. Like, people were giving ugly laughs in the crowd. Like, it was
my awesome. First legal rated movie was Clerks 3, so I'm throwing that in there.
That's great.
Clerks 3 was a fucking... It was
Clerks
amazing.
Was just the old series.
Well, yeah, the old ones are good, but seeing great. Clerks 3 in theater was fucking dope.
I feel like we missed one, but...
Which one?
Oh no!
Oh,
I mean, there's so
there's
many. Like,
they'll pop up when you're driving home.
And like, when I go home, I'll be like, "Fuck, great shit!"
You don't want to say that.
Next one. Okay, let's see how you feel about this next question. Ready? Huh? You go to Pornhub. What's in your search bar?
Damn. Oh, hold on. First of all, you single?
Yeah.
Okay. You just jerking it.
No, he's slanging. he's slanging hoe.
So the list gets longer.
Oh! Do you know what POG means? P-A-W-G.
Oh. I thought I knew.
I but right?
Recently,
I
saw something
know.
Else and I was like, what?
So, what are you thinking?
I thought it was pretty ass white girl.
That's what it is. But what
you had X out of something.
What did you find out? Because somebody corrected me and said that was it. Pussy, I want them. All right, I
just. Pussy, I.
No, so it's pretty ass white girls. Okay, so.
What was the other one?
No, I was asking like what you thought it was.
I heard something else, and I remember thinking that makes sense too, but I forgot what it was.
Okay, because I heard pretty ass white girl too. My bad. So what's in your bar?
Your main porn star.
Both of those.
I'm doing homemade.
Oh, you like that shit? You like the amateur stuff?
He likes the hotel shit.
Okay.
Amateur porn.
I don't need the
it's gonna
fall on the ground.
The lighting all fucked up.
This video's done.
Hold still, bitch.
It's cool to have like the lighting and
the quality, shit.
But I will say, compared to before and now, I could appreciate some good acting.
Yeah, see, some of them are ass, bro. And I'm stuck in the dryer.
I know, right?
I'm stuck in the window. Fuck me. Like, what the fuck? I mean, I guess.
You think
but they also on original now.
Like, you think you can see up my skirt right now?
Yeah. Oh, my
you
God.
You can see it's up here.
Right.
Like, the acting is so bad. Okay, like, so y'all follow that one guy,
From No Jumper, Adam the Plug.
Yeah, him and his girl, Leonard the Plug.
I almost did an OnlyFans account just so I could see him.
Instagram's enough, but I want to see it. Instagram.
I thought she was already. She's not a porn star.
She is a porn star, but like, after the interviews, they fuck these girls. Like they have Violet Myers.
And he took his glasses off. Look at that.
Mad bitches, dog.
Okay. Yeah.
They got mad. Almost. I don't know how much it is.
They got mad bitches.
You seen it?
Yeah, I haven't gone that far.
Yeah. You seen it?
No, but I've seen the girl. I've seen her.
She's fine.
I follow Lena on Instagram. Bad. But I don't want to pay the. I think it's like $8 a month.
$8.
But are you familiar? Are you familiar with Reddit?
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Yeah. So how do you find porn on there? I signed up. Yeah. I can't find it.
Come on, man. Come on, man. Get the secrets up.
I look on Twitter, and I can find it easier on Twitter.
I'm floating.
Nah, he's a fucking genie. You get one wish.
Tell us your secrets.
I want to see how No Jumper fucks.
Give me Lena the Plug. Right?
Lena.
I don't know how I got to the point, but I just type what I want.
He's lying. I don't know how I got there. I got the porn. He put porn first word. Oh yeah, we got you, bro.
Well, I'm done typing. Like,
I don't know how I got there.
So, I don't know how I created the app. Wait, no. I don't know if I made a profile or anything. Okay. I guess so.
Oh yeah,
okay. But you just go to the search bar and type whatever. Okay.
So,
word. Like
so what are you typing?
Yeah, I'll be back.
Yeah, what are you typing?
I'll be back, y'all.
You just pull up. You pull up Reddit, and then you. Let me see.
So what are you looking up?
What's your main go to?
Yeah, what's your girl?
You said homemade.
Kind of girls.
Oh, homemade. That's right.
Well, like if I'm on Reddit.
You been watching White Girls, you know, the Mexican.
Oh, the type?
Yeah.
Everything.
I'm specific.
I go Latina.
Oh yeah.
Okay. So
petite
Latina.
He likes them small.
Really?
Unless it's Violet Myers.
What made you do that?
She's huge titties and ass.
I don't know, bro. Like,
yeah, she's not petite.
Are you making the exception
for her?
What about her? Something made you be like, oh shit.
I think because she's Latina. She looks like.
I told my girl this. I have a thing for weird noses.
She has a bigger nose.
I like Bella Danger because of her nose.
You know,
I like weird shit like that. That's the only weird, I guess,
thing is,
I like.
Is Bella Danger the one that committed suicide?
She's alive. What are you talking about?
I know.
Who's
the one that committed?
Yeah, I like this dead porn star.
This is a porn star?
There was one that committed suicide. I was like, I can't watch her porn because I'm just...
I want to know because I'll watch it.
I will definitely see her.
She's different this
I'll
time.
See the link. I swear to God, I forgot what her name is.
I'm a necrophiliac, bro.
She's alive in this. Oh, God. I'll send you the name then. Sicko. Oh, I see them Bella Danger. Yeah.
Yeah, but I like her nose.
Oh, okay. Well, what do you mean? Like, so okay, you can't do anything with a nose. What are you doing? Are you fucking?
I just like
fucking
the way.
Nose?
Do you think if there was no sex, it would like be better for you? Just wondering.
What do you mean?
I don't know.
What do you mean?
I don't know. Like something sexual. Like
if she has a big nose or a weird shaped nose, I'm like, that's fucking hot.
Always, like in life,
right?
Yeah, you kind of throw me off, cause like.
So then, do you pull up?
You can't fuck like, the nose. You can't
nose.
Check out that schlong.
Okay, this is a real.
The schnoz.
Perfect
the schnoz.
Schlong.
Hot gun right there.
I need that big nose.
I was watching the Royal Rumble.
Try listen to her work too.
ASMR.
I was.
Oh my god.
Hey, her blowing her nose in Kleenex. Not fucking dark. Shit.
And Sarah knows it too. Like,
I love it.
There's a wrestler I saw when we were watching Royal Rumble. Her name's Raquel Rodriguez, and she has like that big nose, like it's a hump.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, man, that's fucking attractive. Like, I like.
Is Sarah nose fucked up?
She has a little lump on her. I don't know. I like.
Well, I mean, what year did you hit her?
What?
I didn't let her. I just kidding.
God damn. I didn't hear Joe. Like, no.
The whole one.
That's when I fucked up a nose.
You like Pinocchio?
Nah, Pinocchio's bad as fuck.
Okay, so then, like, that's weird. Nose is the
like, I like. See, now I'm
excited. No.
I'm
just trying to figure it out.
I like. I'll call her in here.
Motherfucker, like, no. I know motherfuckers who like feet.
That's it.
I'll call her in here right now.
We're talking about weird noses.
I know motherfuckers who like, I won't fuck a girl if she has pretty feet. I gotta see her feet first.
No, I don't shit. Okay, I understand that. What's one feature that points you at, like, that, okay, catch
I like a weird nose.
Oh, aside from you. We know.
Noses!
But for y'all, one feature that catches our attention that, like, oh, okay, man, I'm digging this shit.
I'm gonna text her. Come here and talk about noses.
I'm digging this bitch.
It's always a smile.
Smile?
I do like a smile.
If they got a straight smile and I can see, like,
way more than a nose.
I can see them sucking my dicks up a point. That's great. You know what I mean? Like, that's what it is. Like, the feet are great. You know what I mean? Like, if they're into it, they're not. That's fine. The ass is awesome. I'm not a tit guy either. I mean, but tits are, you know, a plus.
No, all that's a plus, but I, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
No, look, it's nose guy.
The top.
I like weird noses. It's okay. A fetish.
That's weird.
Okay, favorite porn star?
Oh, yeah, yeah. So, I like thick thighs on the other question. Always been tits, always been boobs.
So, are you an ass guy or a tit guy?
More tits than ass. I mean, well, when the lights off, like...
No, it always kind of feels decent,
you know what I mean? But if I'm watching, I'm like...
So, like, are you top heavy or bottom heavy with it? Like, most of your girls, you have you dated girls?
Have or you dated girls?
No.
Women that identify as...
He could be running through bitches and not date them.
I never know what you said.
No, man. And you date women, right?
Women only.
Hey, great.
Have you dated girls?
Are they mostly top heavy or bottom heavy?
I'm open, like...
I think you're more of a titty guy, though.
I'm more titty.
Yeah, look at you. Look at you. Look at you smile. Yeah, I like some titty.
But, like, it don't got to be big. I just like those more.
So then what size too big? Like, anything past double D? Are you with it or no?
There's no such thing as a wrong
right,
size.
Right, there's no such thing as too
big. Even if they're not there and they're small, but they got the fucking...
I don't care, you got scoliosis, bitch.
What you got?
Throw them in my face.
You know what I'm saying?
Everybody has a back injury.
Yeah, I mean... Fuck, dude.
Oh, come here, baby.
Oh, God.
Come here, Sarah.
Mine. So, you know I like...
Hold on. Let me look at your nose real quick.
Mine? I have, like, a bump here.
I love it. Noff likes girls thing. With... Like, so, Noff apparently saying that...
She knows.
I know. I'm the one who pointed it out.
Oh, really?
She sees the girls that I find attractive, and she's like, you like noses. And I was like, holy shit.
So, fuck, like, the holes in the ear, the gauges or anything, it's just the noses?
Just the nose.
So, like, are you fitted or you like that shit?
I'm not offended.
So then,
what if you're like, motherfucker, my nose is normal, so.
Yeah. Or like.
I know, I've always known I have a weird nose.
I like that little bump.
That's genuine. That's genuine.
And his girl knows it, so, like, that's real love.
And she I like, notice it, and then, like, after a while.
She sees the girls, and I'm like.
You like weird noses.
So know, then, what what's her real weird kink? Like in a guy, like what do you look for? Like if you like weird noses, like
you
what
like
do you
weird
like?
Mexicans.
Like, or is it bald guys or like what's up? Like you know what I mean?
I'm funny.
Do you like
human? You can't know that like on a porn star,
she's
dog.
No, she's
like a body part, body part.
She don't watch porn apparently.
I don't.
Okay.
See, like your boy's an extra freak, and you like an extra like nothing.
We're very opposite. She knows I watch porn, but she doesn't.
So when you want to, and she's you, like, how does it work?
He's
like, roll over, I'm going to do this right now. Like,
right,
when you're in a relationship and you're watching porn.
Like, are you always acting on it, or are you, like, just watching it for fun sometimes?
Like
if are you always jacking off when you watch porn, or are you, like, can watch it without jacking off?
I can watch it without jacking off.
So, like, yeah. Story. So we're on that level, okay.
Is that weird?
No, I've done that.
I can appreciate a story, but I don't think I would use that as my selection.
It's like a movie. It's a movie.
You can watch Forrest Gump in them times.
You could have been watching Forrest Gump. He's watching porn.
You're like hairy wrist or something or what? Like, what's going on? Because you're fucking full of hair. I don't know, dog. I was asking.
Oh, yes. I was looking at the hairy.
Yeah. It was his feet.
We knew it.
The feet.
Remember I showed you the Raquel Rodriguez from WWE?
Yeah.
She has that bump. I'm like, she's kind of hot.
And you didn't know why.
So what do you think about Noff's nose?
That's why I like it, because I have the same big ass nose.
Well, I don't think you got a big ass nose, though.
Is it?
I got a bigger nose than you.
It's not that big.
All right, sir. I just wanted to see. I mean, I appreciate you.
Well, you didn't want to see. I told me not to text her, but I still did.
No, I didn't say not text her.
I knew you were.
You saw me, right?
Yeah, I was like, I would have texted her.
No, it's encouraging that, like, you and your girl, like, know you're weird together. You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all on the same page. Like,
she gets it.
Yeah, like, fuck, I gotta worry about that bitch because she's
like, I gotta
bitch had nose surgery. I gotta worry about this hoe now. God damn it. Yeah, she don't worry about girls with big tits or ass. Like, nah, that bitch with the nose over there fucking my guy up.
She seen me watching old WWE videos. She's like, oh, he's watching Triple H again.
God damn, Triple H spitting the goddamn water up
with his big ass nose.
Big ass nose, broken. Fuck. Hey, Sarah's like punching her nose like at the side.
Give me the Triple H.
God damn it.
Slamming the door in it.
It's gonna look like Owen Wilson in a minute, bro. Owen Wilson and shit. She's just like, wow. She's all nasal problems by the end of the whole.
Okay, thank you, baby.
Thank you.
All right, so I try to get rappers to freestyle.
Yeah,
but a lot of them fuck up because I pick the beat.
Okay.
And I try to pick pop beats.
Okay. Well, guess what?
Can you freestyle?
Today's your lucky day.
Oh, shit. Hold on.
How do you feel? I'll tell you what I'm about to put on.
How much?
No, just play it. Just drop it.
Ooh.
I was playing. I don't know if I'm going to kill it or not. But.
No, because usually this is where I'm like, oh, I got to cut this.
Yeah. Yeah, if you got to cut it, you know? Okay. But if not.
Yeah, okay.
You better keep that shit on.
My boy is getting shit now. What's up?
Are you going to hop on now?
Ooh. You going to hop on? X-Rap for now?
Yeah, you hopping on? I heard you freestyle. When's the last time you freestyle?
No, he was in the studio today.
I wasn't freestyling.
I don't give a fuck. Put it out.
So rhymes are fresh in your mind.
Oh, hey, look, he loves the Miley Cyrus.
It's that one song, right?
It's
popping right now. If you're able to freestyle to it.
Oh, is that as loud as it gets?
I mean, I'll bring it close to you, bro.
Okay, Ty, you hopping on or what? Is that as loud as it gets?
Yeah.
I can't hear it.
Oh shit,
okay, I kinda can. Okay, give me a topic of word or something.
Oh, flowers.
Let's build a memory.
Pussy.
Oh, pussy.
She said, come over, said in the hour. She said she got a pussy out the shower. She said it smells good, just like some flowers. I said I'm chasing toys that I won't cower. I see I'm jumping on it, I'm on a tower. Up in Austin. Like the powers,
hey.
I got a gold medal. She wanna taste it. I said, damn, that shit is amazing. She said, I'm beating it up. I'm courageous.
Hey.
I'm sip drink for a loco, and I got it in the tank. Now rob that shit.
Yeah.
Like X at the bank. Fucking smoking that shit. We on dank. Fuck what you want. For like John Statham, I get it cranked.
Hey.
I get it
cranked.
Like Lil Jon, what you want? What do you know? It's the boy D. I'll freestyle, hop with a no for bone on the flow.
Yeah.
I gotta go, I'll make the noise. She from Chicago, Illinois. I put an S at the end, cause I'm iller, plus I make noise.
Hey.
Never shy, I'm never coy. It's Corey that shot, right?
Yeah.
Either way, I'm back. Either way, I'm all up in the limelight. I rhyme tight.
Hey.
Back to the Corey. I beat it up. I'ma destroy.
Hey.
I'm with Lil Jon. I'm on the east. I'm on the side. I'm with the
east.
Hey. Boys. East Side Boys. That was what we were saying earlier.
Hey.
It's the white D. I still freestyle. I go every day. I'm going wild. I feel like Eminem. I'm on the mile.
Kill this shit,
I sip an eight. I sip a drink. I take a tape. I freestyle. I go to the crates. Just like Donkey Kong.
Hey.
Cause I ate a lot of times, a lot of rhymes. I'm like the star, I'ma just shine. I'ma do whatever it is. Then I transform, I'm optimist. I'm
pride.
Like pride.
Yeah.
Fuck it. Miley Cyrus, I put her on a bucket. Just like the hat, then I go get it. It's the boy D, I get to the digits. That wasn't even a word. I was chilling.
Not with the midgets.
Yes. The midgets, and I wrote. And like I had wrote it, I just be rapping. I am atrocious. I saw the girl, she had a nose in. I beat it like I was DeRozan.
Mid-range, ho.
Yeah, I exploded. Okay, I be going. I'm not a sheep with horns, but I'm still goated. Throated. I say I'm just flowing. I just be flowing. I'm going in the moment. My aura's not silver, it's not platinum, but that shit was so golden. All fourloko, they didn't have the golden.
All y'all suck.
You did the whole beat.
I was waiting you to hop in.
My boy,
no, but you killed the whole thing.
Man, my boy don't need no amateur porn no more. We professional porn now. Y'all getting some good lighting.
All of you
better acting.
Better rapid lighting, dog.
All of you passed on flowers because you wasn't feeling it. Take notes.
Woo, shit.
That was cool.
Any beat.
Hey, so, all right, before we end it, we do a talk can venting where you can vent about anything you want.
I would say it like the internet.
Okay.
Right? I hate social media.
You don't like social media?
I don't. And is I don't want to sound like over like any fucking post that you'll hear, but like the internet, everybody lives their life on this like spectrum where you have to be accepted and liked by people. Right?
No.
People you don't give a fuck about.
Yeah.
People you never even met. You want more people to like you.
Yeah.
Because there's a status, so then other people who are watching are like, that person's cooler than that person, so I want to follow this person. Even if they follow you, right?
Yeah.
What does it mean?
No, okay.
What do you
expect? Is it weird? I don't like watching our episodes of the Talk campaign.
I stopped watching after season one.
Episodes?
I don't like watching
our shit. I'll edit them and put them out.
To mix them, but I don't like watching myself or us.
Do you watch your own shit?
Because it's you and you created it, or because you don't want to watch?
No, like... It's like, I don't know how to put it, like, it's different because I don't want to watch myself and, like, I don't like it, like.
I've watched our episodes because I've edited them, and I'm like, I don't like.
Do you watch your own music videos?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You have to listen to your music all the time, though, right?
Yeah.
But there's some shit, like, you're like, oh, fuck. You know what I mean? I wish I could have done better.
That's a really
good point. I don't want to be narcissist too either.
Yeah, no.
I feel like if I watch myself, I'm like, oh, I'm too much about myself.
You want, because of what kind of what I said, not in a bad way.
Yeah.
It's the world we live in.
Yeah.
You want people to care. And you want people to judge you based on the best version of you. So like an interview when you go to work somewhere, you want to, if you could play back your interviews, you would know every fucking breath you took that was like, fuck, I shouldn't have done that.
Yeah.
But it happened.
I want them to naturally love me. Not forced.
Right.
I don't want to shove it down their fucking throat with like, oh, well, I have to like you. You're everywhere. Everyone else likes you. Nah, man. You like me for me and us, that's cool, man. If not,
So how do you feel about, like, we brought this up before. With Tolkien, I don't do the whole, oh, here's our new episode, let me tag 99
fucking people, though.
How do you feel about that?
I hate this.
For me,
I know rappers who do it.
I would never tag that many people.
Good.
The downside is, it's people that tag me I never met in person.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
That's weird.
Yeah, you know see, what I'm I've been tagging shit. I'm like, bro, like,
We'll do it.
Yeah.
Out of courtesy.
But there's one that's in promotion like, and I'm going to call them out. But I'm like, I've never intended your show. I've never seen your show, but stop tagging me with the other 98 of us.
I want to call them. You want to call them?
No. I'm never in your show, bro. Stop tagging me.
What's an example of some shit you shouldn't do that will be fucked
okay,
up?
Okay, as a rapper, don't mass tag me on your fucking music video. Yeah. Right. All of us, like 98 of
us. I think you find it annoying, right? Or do you get it?
Oh, no. Super fucking annoying.
Okay.
But I will say, because you're media.
Okay.
And people who don't have resources. I have a lot of resources because I move around. Because I had to figure out.
Resources mean the people who are on daily
social media. People who have reach.
So people who aren't on social media daily need that us to repost, right?
If I don't understand social media, I can watch all the YouTubes in the world. Right now, my numbers on social media don't match what the research I've done.
He's like teaching me. And it's tough. He's like
my main.
He's like there's like a time you're supposed to post
all that, and it changes.
My main Facebook has more reach than Talkan. So lately, I've been posting through the main page, tagging Talkan because
he's got 3K.
Because I'll post a video on Talkan, 3 likes on my own page. 50. It's like,
but you have like 3K followers, though.
That's what I'm saying. Like, it's
he's a social media whore.
I'm trying to get. I mean, I've got.
No, no, like,
You know what I mean? Like I respect that shit, though. Yeah. You fucking built that shit, though. Yeah. You just built that shit. That's hard over years.
The way that, like, you just want people to see it because you know. Like, if someone really wasn't doing that, then they weren't watching porn on free or for free. Wasn't watching Forrest Gump again.
That's me.
Every time before I went to sleep, you know what I mean? I was Forrest Gump.
Yeah, you can, dog.
But
Bubba.
It's billions, millions of shit on the internet. So you have to select. Some people watch the same shit all the time. You know that you're funny. You know that you're interesting. That's why you still do it. Yeah. The numbers, if when you started 2-3 years ago?
Yeah.
Two years.
Yeah,
if 2 years ago, if I said, here's what your numbers are going to be in 2 years, you probably would have quit then.
Yeah.
But because you see reaction.
No. X doesn't like our numbers right now.
I don't like our numbers now, but...
That's why I'm getting
that. That's why I'm watching, though. But, Knopf goes, these are better numbers than when I was a rapper.
Yeah.
So I go, all right. I don't like being narcissistic watching my fucking stuff all the time.
Yeah.
But I'm also not going to be fake either. I'm not any type of, like, fake, bro. Like, if I don't like it and I don't think we should support it, I won't do it. I'm here every week. Knopf does all the work. Knopf does a lot of fucking work, man. So I feel bad. Like, I think I'll let him down if I don't come up and give my all. Make y'all fucking laugh. Like, make you fucking laugh.
Yeah.
Make him comfortable. Make him fucking, make his job easier. That's all it is. I want perfection, but like I'm too hard on myself.
He wants those high numbers.
I want the high numbers, but he goes through the process. I'm learning it. I didn't.
And you know, as a rapper, it's a long process.
You know, I'm learning the social media thing. He's been through it. He goes, we're doing better now. I was a rapper ever.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, then that gets my hopes up.
Yeah.
But I don't.
All my progress, bro.
Yeah, we're not, you know, Joe Rogan.
No,
but we won't. You know what I mean? We won't be realistically.
We're saying.
No, it's just, it's a process.
Yeah. But like, he does a lot of work, and I love him for everything. I try to tell him, without Knopf, there'd be no talking. And period. I'll tell you straight up right now. You know what I mean? I would do anything for this guy, though. You know what I mean? Like, me and Knopf, like that. So, if he wants my show and we keep going, I'm going to rock till the very end, bro. I told him that from the very beginning to the very end. And I love you, dog.
Yeah.
Give me some. Give me some.
Emotional moment. I love it.
There you go, dog.
We'll never forget this moment.
You know what I'm saying?
You know?
Eating this bitch. Hell yeah.
So, he's at the beginning as well, man.
Like, honestly, like, everything I was saying is the exact same thing. It's ass sack. I can't talk no more.
We're Slizzard. The fucking Four Lokos, bro.
Tight. We built the memory, and I'm big on that.
No, we're taking pictures with the cans, bro.
Honestly, like...
I ain't even opened this one. I'm about to open it right now.
That's what I was saying. So 2 years ago, if I told you these are going to be your numbers, you wouldn't have wanted to do it.
Yeah.
Because we have this expectation of what we see and what we compare to. Because we're not going to compare ourselves to the person that has 500, whatever.
Like, we're not going to compare ourselves to Joe Rogan.
You would like to.
That's a problem. That's a huge problem, bro.
You see that. And he's cool. He's funny.
Yeah.
He has good guests.
Yeah.
But like, I watch this, I'm not laughing as much as I'm laughing right now.
It's all 3 hours.
So in my head, I'll be honest, in my head, we're top five in the city. Easy.
Podcast.
I mean, we don't have great quality.
An interview was like,
do it. It's hot, bro.
Definitely.
You had fun. Got it.
Right?
Right? Motherfucker, you had fun.
My eyes focused.
You would have jacket.
He's gonna rip my chain.
Tell me you had fun. We're all holding it.
I had one guy tell us, like, y'all are the greatest do it yourself podcast. Because, look at
this. DIY.
Yeah.
What did Live tell you?
Live said we were the funniest
podcast you've done on.
And to hear that from Live.
Because we're not being shit over when I try to act
all hard. Yeah, Live was like, y'all goofy.
You know what I mean?
It was fun.
We're not like, what was it like, dog? You know what I mean?
I asked the motherfucker how he felt about corn.
Boring, dog. Everyone does that shit, bro.
We try to switch it up, you know?
That's exactly what I mean. Like, being yourself, it separates you. And it doesn't feel right because the only thing you have are two things. The numbers that you thought you wanted to see.
Yeah.
And the things you hear that you take in.
Yeah.
So whenever you see numbers, what do you have to compare to? Yeah, people in the city, sure. But they started or have certain connects or have certain people or money that you can't really compare.
Yeah.
It's not the same shit. So for music, for me, there's a lot of rappers. I don't compare myself because I have my lane.
Yeah.
So it's the same thing.
So we
so had, this is our lane had, right now, which is kind of cheap, but yeah. I mean.
No, we had a meta podcast. We had a meta podcast.
It truly does not matter what it is. What matters is that it's genuine. And you keep trying to reach people.
Yeah.
Because people who want something different. One day, the fucking girl whose dad is in a room, who she's a millionaire, and they're gonna hear you, and you're gonna end up like fucking Wayne's World. Remember that shit? Same shit.
Yeah.
They had to recreate his room because it was them, and it couldn't be them because they were trying to be that shit.
For sure.
Perfect example.
Yeah. You can only go up from here, bro.
Yeah.
You can only go up.
Where you going, Brooklyn? Bro?
Hell, yo.
Oh, the seal's broken.
I probably broke this shit. What was it, like an hour? How long has it been?
Good. You haven't gone either.
I'm holding my shit.
I never
we all gonna go.
Yeah, honestly, like, and, you know, not to take it random, but, like, I'm big on it.
Yeah.
So, a lot of people have been doing it a long time. The fact that I've been doing it longer than most and still Instagram numbers look like I'm doing this and that is hard for the average person to take that and keep going. So where rappers have like, well, this is my image or whatever. I don't have a fucking image on me. Mm-hmm. But what I represent or stand for is to keep going, never give up. And not in a corny, like a motivational way. He's motivational, no, but like for real, like I'm out here doing this shit for way longer than everybody else who's already on.
Yeah.
And I know I fucking am better musically than this person. I know I fucking work harder than this person. I know I can bring more people than this person's getting paid. I know.
Yeah.
It's not like I think. I know. I see it. I go to these people's events. So all the things that I would like to compare, nothing is true. But then when you go to places where you think nobody knows you, and they're like, hey, aren't you so-and-so?
Yeah.
It's a reminder. Good. Yeah. So those little things are what makes you keep wanting to go. So even if it's one comment out of 20 that actually stood out, because you're gonna hear comments on YouTube that's like, hey, good shit, that was funny. When I get off stage, I practice so much to be, are you good?
Yeah. Oh, my bad, dog. My bad, dog.
When I get off stage, I practice so much to be comfortable on stage. So I'm more humble than most of the people you come across, but I fucking know. Like, I know. I know what lyrics I put in that you might have not caught that I still was, you know what I'm saying?
To your lyrics, you gotta pay attention.
And if you don't, I still try to deliver it to where it was like, damn, I like this song. But when you listen, it's like, oh, fuck. But a lot of people aren't doing that. So I know I'm not gonna get the things that would make me be like, oh, hell yeah. But I do have to grab onto the little things that make me think it's worth it. And that's what keeps you going. And eventually, all it really takes is one person. Have you ever been in sales? You know, they say one sale could change your whole day. It's rare, but the internet is limitless.
Yeah.
So always treat everything like it's your first impression.
There you go, man.
Honestly.
Let's go back. The freestyle was fucking dope. I appreciate you actually doing it.
Yes, sir.
Shout out Miley Cyrus.
Definitely. Man, that was cool. That was fun.
He can buy himself flowers, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I
should. So, do you want to shout out your social medias?
Mm. Yeah, so DiversiD Music. DiversiD is spelled DiversiD. So
capital D.
Yeah, capital D. The way you know I spell DiversiD, instead of a T-Y at the end, it's a D. DiverS.
Can I have that in a noun? In a sentence, I'm sorry? So it's just spelling bee?
DiversiD performed at the Zero Show. The next day. So search DiversiD anywhere. DiversiD Music on Instagram. DiversiD Music on YouTube.
Yes.
Shout out to All About Growth Entertainment.
Sir.
Shout out to Stilo Jordan, engineer, photographer.
He's dope.
Producer.
Stilo!
Yeezer. He's on the show also. Shout out to E-Twist. Cold ass fucking rapper.
Oh, that was E. My bad.
Shout out to E also for being in the room.
Just add you right now, dog.
Hell yeah.
You barely added that person. Fucker. Fuck up, bro.
Fucker. I had a song with you 10 years ago. Now he wants to add you.
Cause I'm sipping. This brain got me tripping.
Performance acoustics. The guitar is
on this song right now.
Off air is it. Only fan shit.
Kill that shit. We'll make it happen. Shout out to AR, the manager, DJ, PR.
Oh, she's cool, man. She's cool as fuck.
You miscommunicate. No,
there's some miscommunication.
Get your chimes right, chick.
You good people, we love you.
Get your shit right, man.
We love you.
Who else? Definitely Case, other manager.
Okay.
Inner City Bang.
Yeah.
Inner City Bang is a producer. He's the one that made That's Fire.
Bow.
I have a song called Gremlin. He made that beat.
Bang.
And some other shit that's not out yet. I have so much
just
shit.
Just waiting.
Much shit. I'll send it to y'all exclusive.
Well, please, man.
For shit.
I'm going to leak that shit for some money.
Here's that new diversity.
Go ahead and send that shit all you want.
Gotcha. I fuck with y'all. It was cool.
Hey, definitely come out hoop with us. It was a pleasure. Yes. Fucking. I tell you what. You probably one of our favorite rappers having on this show.
Yeah,
definitely. I mean, we're 2.5 hours deep.
I'm 2.5 hours in. I'm fucking this three.
Hey, what's funny? Hey, we told him, I was like, we go 45 to an hour. Hey, unless the conversation
we all
good.
I mean, we may go 1 hour 30 if
it's yeah, and then he put out the Four Loko.
2 hours.
I got something for
yeah,
you.
Yeah, man.
We go at three.
Basically, he roofied us. Shout out to all Ken. Thank you so much. I
hope you enjoyed your time.
Yeah, man, bro. Out, bro.
This shit was
until
cool.
Again, bro. Until again.
I gotta come back.
Dope, for sure, bro.
You got to.
This shit was cool.
And this was another episode of Tall Can.
Hit it.
Listen it. Oh,
you almost break that shit. Yeah.
Tall Camp.